Hi there, this is Sarah, your socially awkward seller, and I thought I'd bring you another video about the new reseller series that I've been doing. And it's been a while since I put one of those out, so I thought I would do one today. And we're going to talk about basically about 10 or 12 categories of things that you need to get started on eBay. And this will probably apply to Poshmark as well, or any reselling platform. So let's just jump right in. Obviously, if you want to start reselling on eBay, the first thing you need is an eBay account and a PayPal account, because at this time, most people, not all people, most people are having their money from their sales be deposited into a PayPal account. That's what I do, and I will continue to do that until basically we're forced to go to the new accounting system and banking system. But so I would go ahead and get signed up for an eBay account and a PayPal account. And there will be some limitations on your eBay account if you're new. And I have discussed that in a prior video, I believe. Understand too, and I won't go too much into this because I really want to just talk about the physical things that you need, are that when you make your first sales, there will be some holds on your PayPal account if you're a new seller. So you may not be able to access that money except for the shipping immediately. But anyway, let's move on past that. You will need internet access, and that could be data on your smartphone. It could be your Wi-Fi connection at home, which brings me to the next two things that you need. Either a smartphone or a computer. I have both, and I use both to run my business. The smartphone I use for when I'm out and about to look up items for resale to see if they would be profitable. I also respond to messages when I'm not at home that I get from eBay or from a potential buyer on eBay. I also respond to offers that I get when I'm away from home using the smartphone. And a lot of times I do that even if I am home sitting on my sofa. I'll use my smartphone. It is important, I think, to have a computer, but it is not 100% absolutely necessary. That being said, there are some things that you cannot do on the mobile app on eBay, and things like making a sale, like creating a sale, and bulk editing and things like that, that are much easier on the computer using a browser. You can access a browser on your smartphone, of course, and go to the eBay website. It is a little cumbersome doing it on your phone just because of the size of the screen. Obviously, you can do it on a tablet. That would give you a bigger screen. But I recommend that you use a computer or a laptop if you have one. It just makes life easier. And I personally prefer to list items on my laptop. It just is better for me. Another thing that you will need is a photo method. So obviously you're going to have to take pictures of the items that you want to sell, and you will need to be able to do that. So you can use your smartphone. Most smartphones now, if they're, within the last couple of years, take really, really good pictures. And of course there is editing software on your phone usually, and you can obviously download apps that will allow you to edit photos if you choose to do that. So I use a smartphone, and what I do is some people upload their photos to the cloud. I'm not sure what the cloud is. It's out there. I know it's out there and it's got my stuff in it, but I really don't understand. Anyway, they'll upload their photos to the cloud and then be able to access those on the computer to make their listings. I don't do that because I'm just not that technical. I can do it. I just don't like to do it. I just use a USB connection to connect my phone to it. Essentially, it's a wired versus an unwired or a wireless connection. I'll just pull the photos off and put them in a folder on my desktop. I like doing it that way. If you don't have a smartphone that takes good enough pictures, you can always use a DSLR, you know, just a camera, and take photos, and a lot of people do that as well. So those are two methods that you can use to take photos. That being said, you'll need some kind of lighting, and you do not need to go out and purchase an expensive lighting system. It is not necessary. There are a couple of options. You can use natural light, which many people do, and they'll just go to the room with the brightest light in their house, maybe with a lot of windows or whatever, and they will use that light and that light only to light their items to take pictures, because you would like pictures that are nice and light and bright so people can actually see the item that you're trying to sell. So natural light works. You can use clamp lights that you can get from Walmart with some daylight bulbs. I mean, it's not necessary for you to go and spend $150 or even $75 on a lighting system. You can actually build your own light box, and there are videos on YouTube to tell you how to do that. For the simplest background, when you're first starting, you can buy one of these trifold boards from Walmart. These are called the trifold display board. This one is not a trifold anymore because I cut it for, I used it as packing material because I don't use this anymore. Those are pretty inexpensive too, and they make a decent backdrop. because you'd like to have that nice white background so that your pictures are not distracting, like nothing in the background is distracting. Printer. You will need a printer because you'll need to print shipping labels. If you have an inkjet computer or printer at home, and that's what you have, use it. You know, use that, and don't invest in an expensive printer in the beginning. I will tell you that those ink cartridges can get kind of pricey, and you will go through quite a bit of ink printing labels. I recommend one of two other methods. That is either to get a laser printer, which I bought mine for about $80 from Best Buy. It is black and white only, and it takes printer cartridges that I buy on eBay for, I think I get two of them for about $25, and they last for a long, long, long time. I think I buy about two a year, and it will depend on the volume of labels that you're printing, but I print about 100 a month, and I'll probably print more than that since I have Poshmark too. Let's say I probably print 125 a month. I will probably only buy two cartridges for the year. Maybe in 10 months, 10 months time I'll have to buy, but pretty inexpensive. So that is one way you can go. The other way you can go is a thermal printer, and those print specifically labels. There are a couple different kinds. Zebra and Dymo are the two that come to mind, but there are others. I want to say that Brother makes one too. Those use little adhesive labels, I think 4x6, and those are pretty inexpensive to operate. However, they can be a little bit of an investment to get started with. So that's an option. And then speaking of labels, you can always print your labels on paper just tape those to your packages. And honestly, that's what I did when I first started. But now because I use a laser printer, I use these two to a sheet adhesive labels. And I print my shipping labels on these and stick them right to my package, like this. And that works pretty well. Those are not that expensive, but again, if you're trying to start low cost, use paper and tape. Let's see, what else do I need? Scale. I have had this scale for years and years and years, and it looks, I mean, it's in terrible shape, but it works. I bought this on eBay for, it was less than $20, and I think you can still buy a scale like this for less than $20 on eBay or Amazon. I'm not putting any affiliate links in this video. You can do your own research and figure out which items you want to buy. I do have a larger scale because I sometimes ship things that are large, and I would not be able to see what the weight is with the large box on this scale. So I do have a larger scale that I bought, you know, after I had been selling for some time. And I use that one when I'm doing larger boxes because it has a display that is on a cord or a cable that you can move away from the actual scale. So I do use that. You'll need to think about shipping. And I want you to think about shipping before you ever sell your first item, because a lot of times we have a new seller that will sell something and not be sure how they're going to ship it. So there are some supplies that you will need, and I'll tell you a couple of sources for those. So the first one is going to be boxes. A couple of sources for those. You can buy eBay ones branded on eBay. You do not have to do this, and this can be a little more expensive. I have these because I have a store, so I have a subscription that allows me to buy, I don't know, $50 worth of supplies every quarter, so I buy these boxes with that. You can also get free supplies from USPS.com. They would be all for Priority or Priority Express. You can't use these for anything else either. This one is a Priority box. And this one is one that you would ship by weight and dimensions. However, they do have flat rate boxes available. I use these flat rate padded envelopes quite a bit. I ship a lot of things in these. Also available for free. They'll ship them right to your door on USPS.com. You can salvage boxes from your local grocery store. My husband sometimes brings me small boxes home because he knows I can use those. And, you know, as long as they're in good shape and they're not alcohol, there's no alcohol, you know, they're not for whiskey or something. You can't ship that through the mail. You can't ship those boxes through the mail unless you obscure the label. You can use those. And then another option is places like U-Haul, Walmart, Home Depot, Lowe's. They all sell moving boxes. Home Depot and Lowe's and U-Haul all sell pretty much larger boxes, but Walmart usually has something in the 10 to 12 inch size that is pretty nice for shipping. Other materials that you may need will be some bubble wrap. I get mine, some people buy it online, some people scavenge it from stores that throw out the bubble wrap. I buy mine generally from Sam's because it's fairly inexpensive and I live 2 seconds from Sam's. I get 240 square feet for about $30, and that is the smaller bubble wrap. So I'm usually have a box of that sitting around. And then I buy larger bubble wrap. It's usually orange, but larger bubble like this at Home Depot, and I think I get a 175 square feet, I think, for about $20 of that. And that's good for larger items more fragile items. So you may want to consider packing paper. I don't use this a great deal because it's not really good for cushioning. Peanuts are good, those styrofoam peanuts. If you're a little more eco-friendly, then you can use biodegradable, but I won't go into all of that. Packing peanuts work really well, but you know, in a pinch, crumpled packing paper can work. I would not use it for super heavy items though, because it will crush in your shipping, in your box. Other things that you may need are poly mailers, and there are a couple options for these. You can buy plain ones that are unprinted. Again, I get these with my shipping allowance, my shipping supply allowance with my store. And you can buy printed ones like this in a variety of sizes, and those are available, and you can buy them on eBay, Amazon, Mercari, and then other outlets as well. Those are nice to have in a variety of sizes. If you can't afford to buy a variety of sizes, I recommend buying something about this size. This, I think, is a 9x12, because a lot of things will fit in this. And you could even make two of these fit together to do a larger package. Bubble mailers, like I use these for first class items. You can buy these again on Amazon, eBay, Mercari. I don't use this size a lot. These are smaller than I thought they would be. But you can also buy them, for example, at Sam's, and they have a decent price, especially if you need them in a pinch. I think you can get 25 6x9 bubble mailers at Sam's for about $7, I want to say, which is good, like I said, in a pinch. I think they're a little cheaper online. But those are some packing materials that you're going to need. You will also want to have tape and a tape gun. It does not have to be a big fancy schmancy tape gun like this one. It can be one of those little rolls of tape that you buy that has the little plastic dispenser. If you're first starting out and you don't have a lot of money, that is possible. A tape gun like this will run you less than $20, and it usually has tape with it. This is, again, branded tape that I bought with my shipping supply allowance with eBay. I recommend, too, that you have a tape measure, because you're going to need that to measure the box so you can enter those shipping dimensions into eBay when you're shipping. Can be either, a tape measure like this. It can just be a sewing tape measure like this. Doesn't have to be sophisticated. You'll also want to have that in case you are shipping or selling clothing, because you'll want to measure clothing. So I recommend having one of those. Can you live without it? Yes, but I recommend that you spend the couple bucks and get one. Let's see, what else do I have on this? You may want to invest in some clear poly bags. It's really nice to put an item in one, just to give yourself a little bit more professional look. It is not necessary, and you do not have to go and buy these self-adhesive printed ones like that. Walmart has a box of bread bags. I think you get 100 for like $3 or $4 that you can use and tape shut yourself. Those are in the Ziploc aisle. You could use Ziplocs. I don't recommend it because they can be a little pricey, but I do have a range of poly mailers or plastic bags. Great for putting clothing in, because I like to give clothing an extra moisture barrier, so that if the package gets wet, maybe the clothes won't get wet. So that's another nice thing to have. Not necessary, but it is nice to have. Let's see. Inventory. You're going to need inventory, and you can ship whatever you or sell whatever you know. And I'm not going to go into all the things that you might sell in this video, because it is an unlimited number of things. If you're just starting, again, the most recommended thing that any reseller will tell you is go around your house and find things for sale in your house. Maybe some old electronics, maybe some old, clothes that you're not using anymore, handbags, whatever. But you will need to get some things together to list on eBay. And then finally, I recommend that you have some cleaning supplies. I use those Clorox wipes or those Lysol wipes for some things. I have a bottle of this Goof Off. I think I got this at Walmart. This is good for taking marker marks off the bottom of shoes. It will do a plethora of things. And it's usually safe for most things. You can use it on most items and it won't damage them. I recommend that if you are selling clothing or cloth items, that you have a lint brush. You probably will need a box cutter. That's what happened here. You'll probably need a box cutter and be careful with using it. And then that should pretty much get you started. I want to make sure I didn't miss anything because I really want to give you an idea of how to get started. Looks like I pretty much talked about everything. Those things, get those things together and get ready to start listing your first things on eBay. Soon I will be making a shipping video where we will talk about how to use the supplies that are available from USPS.com, and either in that video or as another part to that video, I will be showing you how I ship a few items, probably a clothing item, a breakable item, a large item, etc., 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 so that you get an idea of how you can safely pack. I've made videos like this in the past, but it's always good to update because things are always changing. We'll talk about the cost to ship things, whether you should do free shipping or not, which is completely up to you, but I'll give you my 2 cents. That's probably in today's market only worth about 1.7 cents, but whatever. We'll talk about all of those things as the series continues, and I will try to get these videos out to you sooner. I've just been friggin' lazy. I'll own it. I've just been lazy. So anyway, thanks for watching. I appreciate it. If you have comments, please put them below. If I've forgotten an essential item that you think that I should have added to this video, put it in the comments below. Ask questions. I love getting comments and questions from you, and I will answer those as quickly as I can. Like and subscribe. I'd love to see you here more often, and I will see you soon. Remember that the dream works when you do, so keep dreaming and keep working, and I'll see you the next time.